In the recent releases of Safari and Firefox browsers, internet browsers, millions of people, billions of people use both of those browsers around the planet on a day-to-day basis. There's been a massive shift towards privacy. As defaulted when you download these new versions, they operate in a much more strict way and automatically block cookie cross-browser tracking. Now, what does that mean? It starts to get a little bit confusing, but what it means is these big social networks, as you flow around the websites, they won't be able to track you as clearly. So you might see, here's an example, I've been to the brisbanetimes.com.au website after I've been to Facebook, and this message comes up on my browser window by default, with the shield that says, hey, Firefox has stopped a social network from tracking me. So when I click through to find out to see protections, I can actually see that, hey, Facebook has actually tried to track my behavior through this site. And that's pretty much how a lot of the internet works. If this is Facebook, for example, if I visit Facebook and then I start to click around these other websites, they all start to send information back to let Facebook know I've been there. And then they can customize the advertising experience around that. So what's happening is that these browsers are going, nope, we're going to block these messages back. And so it means that these large websites will not have as much data about your behavior as what they previously did. Now that's a massive win for you. In privacy, big tick, happy days. Hey, I'm not no longer being as tracked as closely as what I used to be. But for business, what does it mean? There's a few things you need to consider now as business owners with your tracking data and your performance data on your website. So stats will have less meaning, especially around new visitors versus returning visitors and what that means. So if a person comes to my site and then comes back the next day, it's quite possible that my browser has blocked that message, so I don't know that they're a returning user. They might be still registered as a new user, so your stats will be skewed. Your remarketing will have a massive impact on those ads flowing and following you around on the web. That will be probably reduced in a lot of ways. This is still a moving target. Remember, only Safari, which is, you know, your Apple iPhone, so your stats from your iPhone users will be different. Safari and Firefox. So Chrome hasn't impacted. Chrome still has, you know, 65% of the browser market. So some of those stats are still going to work. Google obviously doesn't really want this to happen because they're the masters of tracking, and they still want to, you know, be friends with every business owner on the planet, so we keep paying them for ads. So there's going to be some impact there. What you need to do as a business is actually start analyzing at a browser level the behavior of users working around your site and interacting with your site. You'll have more information around, obviously, the Chrome browser at the moment will give you a cleaner picture than what the other browsers do. So it's a little bit technical this week, but it's a win for users, not a great win for businesses and advertising agencies and companies and those big players around the world.